Jane, it was such a dramatic day today in court. First off, it's the first time we're hearing from Anna herself of how she killed this guy with the stiletto. So we haven't heard from her. This is the first time she's taken the stand. This is the end of the trial, and she comes out and says that the victim that she killed with the stiletto actually drugged her and raped her. We've never heard this throughout the entire trial, and now here it comes. Shades of Jodi Arias, Jane, she takes the stand. It takes her 3 hours until she starts talking about the night of the murder. Remember, during Arias, we sat right. And we heard tons and tons of testimony until we finally got to the day. Well, this woman takes a stand. It takes her 3 hours. She finally starts talking about the murder. And right when it comes to anything about herself, and she feels bad for herself, she feels sorry for herself, she starts crying. But definitely the most dramatic moment of court today was when her attorney got up there and they started reenacting the fight and showing it, and all along those navy blue 5-inch stiletto heels were placed right in front of her, and you could see that's the murder weapon. The shoes in this trial are the murder weapon, as she's showing, you know, how the fight occurred with her hands and what went on right before she killed him with those shoes.
Well, I'm just blown away. You're claiming at the very end of the penalty phase, basically right at the end of this case, after she's been convicted, she suddenly blurts out, oh, by the way, this guy I killed, who she's now referring to apparently as her fiance, drugged me and raped me during the relationship? Is that what you're saying?
Exactly. She got up there, and that is exactly what she said, that, you know, now she's claiming abuse from this guy. In the past, in the interrogation tapes that we had heard earlier in the trial, she had talked about abuse. She talked about abuse from ex-boyfriends and past boyfriends. But remember, when she took the stand at the beginning of her testimony, she talked about how he's a good man, he was a sweet man, and he was a kind person. But now, at the end, she's claiming abuse.
Well, you know, it's so, Jodi Arias, Wendy Murphy, former prosecutor, the idea that at the end of the penalty phase, just a little while ago, she blurts out, oh, by the way, he drugged me and he raped me during the relationship. This guy that just a couple of minutes earlier she was describing as a kind, charming man. Totally Jodi Arias, you know, one extreme to the other. But isn't that idiotic for her to do so? A, they've already convicted her. B, now she's giving the jurors a motive for why she might want to wipe him out because of past behavior. She's offering a motive for murder now.
It, not only that, I mean, it really makes her sound particularly selfish that she would erect this, not as a defense, but in an attempt to get a discount. So she wants the stiletto as weapon discount, as if going like this was all she did with the shoe, and mix that together with, oh, I forgot to tell you about the abuse during our relationship. Look, if there's a self-defense claim that you killed excessively, because that's really why she lost this case, if you overkill someone because you've got this built-up rage after years of abuse and drugs and rapes and so forth, you might want to bring that up during the trial. Otherwise, the jury, and in this case, whoever decides the sentence, that person's going to say, excuse me? You think we're going to believe that now? No, and now you want to smear the victim to try to get yourself a discount? No, we're going to add
basically
time onto your sentence.
You kill the man, then you destroy his reputation as well. And again, it's giving me flashbacks to the infamous Jodi Arias murder trial. We all remember Jodi, who was also convicted of murder and fought for her life in a dramatic show and tell during the penalty phase. Remember, she held up that shirt and told the jury that she suffered from domestic violence. Okay, so this is the trick that she used. And guess what, Simone Bien? In Jodi Arias' case, it worked. In her penalty phase, they hung. They did not send her to death. It was an 8-4 vote. So Anna's jury is made up of 7 men and 5 women. It's the same dynamics here. Could it turn out that this resonates with one guy or one woman on this jury, and then they hang? And, you know, she basically avoids the responsibility of having killing this man.
I don't think so, Jane, is my gut feeling. Now, what we know about Jodi Arias, she was a brilliant liar. And she just kept talking and talking and talking about her abuse. And she talked about, you know, abuse in her past. with, well, she was pretty good. She was a good talker, that's for sure. But certainly here, Jane, what I think is, I do not think a guy, I think it will enrage a guy, I think it will enrage women, because it is insulting to rape victims, it's insulting to men, and it's insulting, like you say, to the reputation of this guy, who, by the way, of course, is now